So, Alan, let's go back to the beginning. Why did you quit your job at British Rail to set up your own record label?
It was basically because it was a lot of people were dying on the tracks. And after one person actually jumped in front of the train and I saw the sort of like the horrible sort of reality of somebody dying, I decided it wasn't for me. And I'd always loved music, and I decided, well, you know, people might die over music, but they don't actually jump in front of a record. So that was actually why I done it. I think creation stands for taste. I think that's why, I mean, we're starting like a new book venture and we're like going back into management, and we've already started entering the world of publishing. It's really everything that I stroke creation I'm connected with is all in the best of taste, and it always has been. And it's like we could never like sign a Sabrina or something like that, because that isn't where my heart lies. It's always to do with the thing that basically I must like the artist, or I must like the project, you know. I mean, you know, it's 100% selfish, the whole idea of the label, you know. But I mean, I don't think there's actually anything wrong with that, you know. As long as, you know, ultimately, do you know what I mean, you're quite fair with people as well, you know.
You've talked about bands that have been signed to the label and how they're to your taste. Tell us a little bit about each one. Let's start with the Weather Prophets. What sort of distinguishes them from the common herd?
I think really mainly songwriting ability. I think that Pete Astor's really... He's got some real sort of like classics ideas to songwriting, but he in a way that sounds hackneyed and really boring, but I think he sort of like performs it to such a level that it's sort of such perfection that it's a total art for him, you know. I just think basically as well, you know, I mean, they should be much, much bigger than they are, you know. I mean, I think it's quite funny that people like Lloyd Cole or like pop stars and Pete Astor still really languish in obscurity. It's sick, really.
Our heads are above water, definitely, but it's we miss the money. But I mean, you don't want to just give it up because you're not making lots of money. You can keep going until the respect balances up with your bank balance. Yeah.
Well, it's nothing like any of the sort of chart stuff or anything that's going around just now. It's definitely got a character. The label's sort of got a real character to it that is different from most labels, I think.
Creation sort of guaranteed sale is only worth to us. Not much, only, you know, nothing more. It's no big deal. Do you know what I mean?
We're not really part of the kind of the old kind of household kind of Creation, because we're just like new on the label. And a lot of the fans that have been buying Creation stuff over the years kind of haven't really got out. So got this,
I don't know. I mean, I know. There has been releases on Creation that have sold even less than 1,000. Mm.
Signing to Creation was the sort of turning point for you, Kevin, because you were going to split up, weren't you?
Well, we weren't exactly going to split up, like we weren't going to leave each other, but we were going to get rid of the name of the band and that kind of thing, you know, and start off playing a few small gigs. But I sort of kept my Bloody Valentine name going, for better or for worse.
I don't know why, really. Just for some reason or other, people wanted us to play some gigs, and we said, okay, we'll do some more gigs with Bloody Valentine, and just kind of went off from there. And then Alan kind of, we did a gig with Biff playing Pow, And then after that, he wanted to sign us.
Basically, we were just meandering on, you know, which looked like it was going to stop eventually. And then the creation thing sort of, you know, made things actually move.
Then we've got a group, well, we've got a group called Primal Scream, who you, of course, are aware of, and you've interviewed them now. And Primal's sort of like, they're away in Italy today, playing a festival where they're apparently quite well known, you know.
I would say we're a rock and roll group. Really, and I think there's a lack of rock and roll groups in the contemporary music scene at the moment, so that's all I can say, we're a rock and roll group.
If you're talking about in a business sort of like, way, then I don't think we do compete, but I don't think any independent really competes with CBS or somebody like that. But if you're talking about like in a sort of way of taste and a way of sort of art, then I don't think CBS are in my league really, because I don't think there's anybody working in the whole company that actually understands music, bar maybe like Muff Winwood or somebody like that. I think apart from that, you know, like, I mean, if you spend your whole life listening to music, eventually some of it rubs off, and I think that's what happened to sort of creation, you know. I mean, it's just run by enthusiasts more than it's run by business people, you know. We've got a group called Felt, okay? It's run by a lunatic called Lawrence.
We just want to make good records, records that we're happy with. You know, we're not concerned with fame, money, nothing like that at all. Just want to make great records. We're going to make 30 albums and then stop. We've made 10 so far, so we have another probably 15 years ahead of us.
So why 30?
Well, it's just a plan from when I started the group, you know. Everything was planned when we started the band in 1980. We had sort of a master plan drawn up and we're sticking to it.
Curious because it's me kind of embracing a much more popular style of music and something I've always liked secretly and furtively myself, which is sort of disco and up-tempo kind of or house music with a kind of Euro disco chord sequence on top. And I'm just curious to see whether that's possible in an indie situation, you know, because I'm still in creation and it's still possibly more wise on creation to be jangling guitars and things, which I've never done, at least not for 8 years or something.
I think creation's image is changing anyway, though.
They're trying to do that, yes. They're with Pacific and groups like that as well, yeah. The inexplicable charisma of the rival. You said describe for me the hairstyle of the devil. Is he passionate?
But I think creation's changing as well.
Yeah.
It encompasses many more things than it used to, so it's good for creation. I mean, Momus is not really your average. I don't think there is an average creation band now, hopefully.
And Alan McGee is sort of completely behind what we're doing, in a way. It, like you said, it sort of encompasses a change in their attitude as well.
If they can carry on all different directions, because they've still got people that were like their older what people will expect from creation.
Yeah.
We've got lots of other things as well. Seems a good base for us because it's... because they're prepared to accept it. So go on and go on. Put your mind on what you love. Fickle friends come and go as the dark side of happiness grows. We never sent tapes to anyone.
It's because we didn't have a tape.
There was this big lie in Record Mirror about that we sent them like a wonderful demo tape when we were called the Doris Days. And we had all these record companies write to us and say, oh, well, can we have a copy of this wonderful tape? No, we don't send out tapes, but it's because we didn't have one. And then, how have you met Alan?
You knew him vaguely, didn't you, when you were talking?
I'd done a club for a few years ago, and I'd booked bands with him for a long time ago. And we met up, and I just said what I was doing, and he said he was interested, and that was the sort of thing he wanted to pursue, especially technology and samplers, and he'd never really experienced anyone using them. And from someone from a similar background as him, sort of experiment with them, he seemed to be quite excited by it. So that's, and he just came around to our room and we were practicing. So it all seems really natural to do it.
Yeah.
Like that. And we, all these horrible people from major labels, they were all really snotty. But, and he was, I mean, he's the only person we, to come around to our house. We asked a lot of other people to, but they never did. Sand.
Well, people are like prejudiced against creation in a way, I think, because it's got this reputation for being kind of jangly rock stuff. And even though I wouldn't say that my stuff's like that, I mean, some of it is actually a bit like that, so it's easy for people to go, oh, yawn, you know, another creation, jangly, you know, internal kind of... bedsitter type anorak person. So that's something that you have to kind of work against, really, you know. That's why I like being on creation, because I don't think, because I think like most of the stuff I do is really not like that. I do quite a lot of dance stuff now, and no one else on the label really does, so it's, I think it's quite nice to sort of stand out like that.
And we've got a group called The Jazz Butcher, and a guy called Pat Fish, who's like literally a pop star in Canada, believe it or not. And do you know what I mean? Of all the places in the world to become a pop star, he's decided Canada as his place. So we're about to get a silver record, I believe, actually. I think you get a silver record at 10,000 sales, and I think we're just about 11,000 sales in Canada now, which is such a small market. It's like the equivalent of selling 100,000 in America. So he's doing well there, and it's like he's a brilliant lyricist. The Jazz Butcher.
I can remember Alan when he was doing his living room club a few years back, and it was just like, oh, it's this weird club, you've got to go there, everyone's playing there. And he seemed a decent sort of chap at the time, but we sort of didn't see each other for a couple of years, sort of with us running around the world. And I suppose we just sort of got on then, and the chance came about to do it, you know. You don't sign anything with creation. You just sort of like, do you want to do something? And yeah, and it's something I'd wanted to do for a long time. I can remember in about like 83 when I was starting to make records and that, I used to like look in the papers and there's all this stuff about creation, and I used to read about the Jasmine Minx and the X-Men and people like that. I used to get dead excited. I used to think they was pop stars. With the label, I don't see, I mean, they've got a vast diversity, and people often think of, you know, they have some kind of picture of a creation sound, don't they, and they sort of get all dismissive about that, which I think is soft, because you've got all kinds of stuff on creation, and, you know, basically for the label, they're just going to carry on making more and more of these releases, and the only thing they've really got in common is they've, you know, got good choruses and stuff, they're good records. I don't see why they should stop. I don't see why in another 5 years they shouldn't be, you know. how do you say it? I mean, in like a media society, you say further up the level, don't you? Yeah. Yeah. Selling more records is what it probably comes down to, and that enables them to put more records out from all over the world.
I'd say just follow your heart, because anybody can do it. I mean, it's, you can still, the music business is, it's still like one, I mean, there's so much bullshit spoken about it, but you can still, if you really believe in it, you can make it work, you know? And it's like, so many people would say, you know, I wouldn't put you through what I've been through, but I would put Andy through what I've been through. I think it's like, there's something really satisfying about like spotting a group, supporting somebody, like how I picked up the House of Love at the Marquee, supporting the Primitives, and it ends up, what, they're going to end up one of the biggest bands in the world. You know, there's something really satisfying to spot a band like that and watch them grow.